Good morning, music educators. My name is Mrs. Kristen Carey, and I would like to invite you to enjoy the pBuzz experience. Open your ears, open your minds, open your hearts as we learn something new together. Many of us are now familiar with the pBuzz and how it functions in elementary schools. It is new to the Bahamas, and today you're going to get a first-hand look at how this entire program went for us. During this presentation, we will explore the method of instruction used for beginner musicians, identify the advantages and challenges of pBuzz in a Ministry of Education's hybrid environment, and we will discuss the takeaways from the initial six-month pBuzz program. Methods of instruction. The recorder is the most popular instrument used in primary schools around the Bahamas. However, the pBuzz gives us an opportunity to try out brass instruments with our young musicians. Here is how we began learning the pBuzz instrument in Centerville Primary School. So, where do we begin with the pBuzz? First, you should teach your students the parts of the instrument. They should be familiar with how to maneuver the instrument by identifying the parts. Secondly, their posture must be appropriate for blowing into the instrument. And thirdly, their embouchure. Playing a brass instrument is not an easy thing. And for these little ones, they may have never been exposed to the proper embouchure for brass instruments. Of course, when we use the recorder, there's a certain way we kind of, some of us encourage them to say two as they're blowing into it, and that kind of gets them to hold back the air so that it doesn't squeak. But this is a completely different ball game if they have never played a brass instrument before. So it takes a lot of practice, and definitely that some of the kids will get it and some of them will get it later. But the key is to keep buzzing. And you're going to hear me say that a lot throughout the presentation, because that's what I would tell my kids. Keep buzzing. Tips for teaching. Students should place their right hand on the pBuzz and slide positions with their left hand. Students should stand as much as possible for supported breathing while blowing into the instrument. Children this age are not yet used to sustaining airflow on a brass instrument. This can make them fatigue if they do not maintain the right posture. Students can practice making a buzzing sound to form their lips and focus the air through the mouthpiece. No puffy cheeks allowed. Before we can make those beautiful melodies come out of the pBuzz, we have to make a sound. Use note values to practice making a sound. Some students may be better on the quarter note, others will thrive on the whole note. Allow them enough time to get used to making a sound in small groups and as a class. So for my group of fifth grade students, we had about 15 to 20. Of course, we were on the hybrid model, so sometimes all of them weren't there, sometimes all of them were. And that was good for us because we were able to just kind of break out into small groups, listen to each other, practice with each other. I would play, they'd repeat, or someone will play along with me, and we would just try and match each other's energy, because it can get a little tiresome when you're first, you're blowing, you're not sure how to pin your lips, you're not sure how to buzz, and you just keep going but you're not getting any sound. It could be really discouraging for these young kids, these young students, who may have never known what it's like to learn an instrument before. I know when I first was learning an instrument when I was younger in my church's band, it took me forever to hit letter B on the clarinet. If anybody knows about B on the clarinet, it took me forever because it uses all of your fingers and it's a higher note. And so everything has to be right for you to get that B to come out. And it finally did. So I know the frustration that my students were going through. So I use fruits to start us off, and half of the class would say the word of the fruit while the other half is blowing for the right time. So everyone feels a part. Everyone feels like they're doing something. Even if they're not getting the sound, they are getting an understanding of what the value should be as they play, how to hold the note, and how to try and sustain that air, which can be difficult at first. But eventually they will get it. So for pair, we would have pair. That's four beats, pair. There is an entire world of pBuzz instruments out there. What we had was similar to the trombone, but there's one called the pBone that looks exactly like the trombone with the bell. There's one that looks like the trumpet. The pBuzz is like the starter version to all these other instruments that can be more specific to the brass family instruments. And the pBuzz, it slides, so it's similar to the trombone, as I said. There are so many resources online for us. There's background music, which we had used during our class sessions. There's sheet music. There's videos with people telling you how you can teach the students. And there's just lots of supplementary resources to make your lesson shine bright. And of course, you can always incorporate whatever the students may be learning in theory with a song and allow them to kind of merge that theory and practical in the way that makes us feel like something's really happening in the classroom. I know both me and Mr. Edward would have just written different rhythms on the board and had the kids use the pBuzz to read them. And so they're multitasking because they've got to make a sound and they've got to read that rhythm. For the first few weeks, some students will begin to tune with each other. Others may be falling behind by an octave, but the goal is to keep playing, practicing rhythms, and to have fun learning. Using the background tracks can be helpful to your group reaching your standard of harmony, whatever that will mean for you. Those with a background in brass instruments would have an advantage with this instrument because of your experience with the same mouthpiece. I found it can be quite challenging to explain to a child who has never heard of embouchure or posture or doesn't know how the airflow is working through the instrument, to describe to them how they're going to pin their lips, how they're going to concentrate the air. I was almost running out of vocabulary words that they would understand, you know, to bring it to their level for them to get that sound out. But I realized the key is practice. And as I'll talk about some of the challenges later, they did not take the instruments home. These instruments, of course, were donated by the Nassau Music Society, so we hadn't really worked out whether students would take them home as yet. And of course, we were on a hybrid schedule, so I wouldn't have seen them as long or as often as I usually do. So those were some kind of things that didn't allow them or afford them the opportunity to practice as much as they should have. But definitely us getting in tune was a process, and coming down to the end of the year, there were about 10 out of the 15 who were there, and a few of us were still so falling behind. A few of them were still falling behind. But practice makes perfect, of course. And this brings us to another section of our presentation. Advantages and challenges of the pBuzz program. Of course, we were extremely grateful that our students would get to experience something new, and without thinking about it or thinking about my own background in brass instruments, we agreed to accept these instruments at Centerville Primary and give our students who had been pretty much suffering from the pandemic in terms of having a music program an opportunity to make some music again. So here were some of the advantages and here are some of the challenges of the program. Number one, having an instrument ensemble at your school is a great way to give students the practical musical experience. Students should be playing instruments. That's point blank. That's what music is all about. Yes, there are so many different avenues in which we can teach music, but for students to really experience what they're learning, it would be great to have some practical lessons or a choir or whatever your school has the resources for. And this was cool because this was something that hasn't really been done or seen, especially having brass in the elementary school. Sometimes we put limitations on ourselves, but we can do great things. Secondly, younger students may not be able to afford a real instrument, I'll say quote unquote real instrument, but they can still begin to develop their performance skills. We know all about the kids whose parents can afford to send them to piano lessons from the age of 4 or 5, or who can purchase them an instrument and give them private lessons. And we know that that really helps us have some talented musicians because they've been playing for so long and they're so familiar with their instrument and they just have all this time and space to grow. But a lot of the students that we see on a day-to-day basis, they don't have that opportunity. And so giving them that exposure is really good because we don't know where they're going to end up. We don't know what area they're going to go into. We could be looking at a Louis Armstrong before us, but you know, if they're not giving the opportunity to learn, then some of them will never reach their full potential. So this exposure was great for them. And thirdly, this is a great start for sight reading, and it's a chance to instill the practice makes perfect attitude within young musicians. So many kids sometimes pick up something and then they give up because they realize it's hard. They didn't have an option to give up in this regard. This was a part of their class. This was a part of their grade. This is what we were doing. And sometimes kids need that extra push so they don't give up. And it's good to instill that from elementary school. So when they do get the bat and maybe playing those harder pieces or they went into a different instrument and it may be more challenging to play, they would know that it takes practice and then you'll see the results. And as long as they have that in their mind, we'll have sharper, stronger musicians. Some of the challenges of the program would be managing your curriculum and a band can be challenging, but time management and goal setting can keep you on track. So hopefully you have administrators and teachers who are cooperative with the time of your practice sessions, or if you go over time, or however you need to kind of ebb and flow to see the results you're looking for. Secondly, hybrid schedules may decrease the instructional or practice time with your students. I only had 35 minutes in each session, so by the time as you distribute the instruments and set everybody up, it can be a little challenging. I also floated this year. So depending on your environment, you would hope that you would be set up in the best way that these challenges would be avoided. And then instruments, of course, come at a cost, which limits the program. So we don't have them in every school yet, but hopefully that they will come. And if it's not the pBuzz, hopefully it could be the pBone or the pTrumpet and the other instruments that are out there. That would give our kids a different experience. Some of the feedback from my students were, "This is fun. I keep losing air. I can't hold my breath that long. This is like a trumpet. I played the trumpet before. Miss Carrie, I can't get a sound." And the most beautiful one of all, "I got a sound. I got a sound." These were the feedback that kept me going throughout the process and kept the students practicing because their work was never done. Even when school closed, we still had some work to do. And that is the beauty of learning and growing together. Okay, it's time for a very short story time. I have never played a brass instrument in my life. Could you believe it? Nope, I am a woodwind specialist, as you may have heard me talk about the clarinet earlier. And I studied voice at UB, and I've had almost 50 voice choir in my school before the pandemic. And so since the pandemic, choir has kind of changed. I was doing handbells And then the pBuzz program was introduced to me, and I did not hesitate to pick it up. As I started teaching the kids, I realized, okay, this is like a real brass instrument. This is next level. And so I say all of that to say, there are no limitations on us as music educators and as musicians. We are still learning, we can still grow. And this experience was new for me and new for the students at the same time. So it was very fun and rewarding when we all got our sounds out. You know, of course, some of us got it on the first day, and some of them, it took them a while to get it. It was rewarding when we started to sound alike and started to keep that one tune going. It was exciting to kind of do a little call and response things together. They would repeat whatever rhythm I'm blowing, and I really got to see them come alive in making music. And this is what our kids need. Sometimes we have a lot of in the book, but when you think of elementary school and the fact that they're with their homeroom teacher all day, music should be a breath of fresh air. Not coming in to take down a bunch of notes and, you know, listen to someone talk. These kids need the doing of learning. And I think this was great for them, especially for my school. I'm so grateful for that the kids got this opportunity, because we had been virtual for a really long time. And music was starting to feel just like another subject. But we're more than that. We have that magic that no other subject can say they have. I think I can say that. I can be a little biased. So the moral of that short story is, we can do great things. And if the pBuzz program is introduced to you at your school, don't feel like you're limited if you have not had background knowledge in a brass instrument. You can do great things. One, two, ready, and pay. One, two, and pay. Last time, go. Good. Now we're going to move on to apple. One, two, ready, and apple. Apple. All right. We're going to do watermelon. This is short. One, two, ready, and.